Works Progress Administration, also known as the WPA, was the largest and most ambitious New Deal agency. The objective of the WPA was creating employment for more than 2 million people during the economic crisis. It created work specially in construction of public buildings and roads. The WPA was instituted by Congress under the Emergency Relief Appropriation Act of April 1935. It was restructured in 1939 when it was reassigned to the Federal Works Agency. In 1936, over 3.4 million people were employed by the WPA programs. 13.5% of the employees were women. As it turned out, the pump priming effects of the federal projects actually stimulated private business during the Great Depression. The result of the WPA was 6,500 1,087 miles of roads, streets, and highways. They built, repaired, and refurbished 1,204,031 bridges, 125,000 public buildings, 8,192 parks, and 853 landing fields. Also, they cleaned slums, revived forests, and extended electrical power to rural locations. They employed 40,000 artists to produce music, theater, sculptures, murals, paintings, state and regional travel guides, and surveys of national archives. The WPA's positive results for the public good and its popularity helped Franklin D. Roosevelt win the next election in 1936. The Emergency Relief Appropriation Act of June 30th eliminated the federal theater project, cut back WPA pay, and limited enrollment for 18 months. With the prosperity in the 1940s, the WPA became difficult to justify, and on June 30th, 1943, the agency was terminated by presidential proclamation.
The WPA gave a lot of jobs during the Great Depression. Due to that, the economy improved, and it gave people a reason for waking up every morning. It helped people recover the confidence in banks, which made the economy flourish.